In the next 10 minutes, you're going to learn how to automate all of your customer emails using AI with the help of this koala bear. Here's what the most basic email workflow might look like. Somebody purchases your product, then you send them a login email or a welcome email. That simple situation where you're sending that one email, that one login, or the one email with their receipt can escalate if you want to follow up. If you want to wait a period of time and then send another email. Before you know it, this is your life. This is a reactive, event-driven workflow. We wanted full control. We want access to our data and our database at every single step of the journey. We want to have code-level ownership, and this means that all of the code and the driver of our workflow exists in our repositories and that we own that. We want flexibility and ease of use, and this is hugely important because we want to iterate and improve the customer experience over time. We also want to be able to develop and test locally. And as the cherry on top, we want to be able to use generative AI to create some of the content for us. We have absolutely no interest in building, managing, maintaining, or otherwise having to construct a lot of infrastructure to handle our workflows. Instead of owning, operating, building, maintaining, and otherwise having to deal with a ton of infrastructure, we're just going to use ingest. So let's dive into some code and see how we went from this into a working email automation workflow. Inside of our monorepo, we have the lesson completed function. As we scroll through the file, you'll see lesson completed is exported, and this is actually an ingest function. So we're calling ingest.create function. And we pass that a configuration. The second option in our function is the trigger. And in this case, we're triggering the function on the lesson completed event. Finally, we have the function handler. And this is an async function. And it's passed several arguments. In this case, we're using event and step. Event carries context that we're able to pass in. So in this case, we are passing in the user, so we have access to the user ID. And then if you go down a little further, you can see that we're actually passing in data, like a lesson sanity ID, so we can look up our lesson module. The step is what actually drives our function. So you'll see right away, the first thing that we're going to do is check and see if this particular user is unsubscribed. So is unsubscribed is an await call to step.run. What's occurring under the hood is that ingest is going to actually call this function, and it's going to call it for each step. So when I call step.run, check if the learner is unsubscribed, I'm able to do some asynchronous work in here. In this case, I'm calling our Redis server and checking for this unsubscribed key. If they're unsubscribed, then it's going to return a value. If we have that value, then we can just return. We're going to quit and opt out of this function altogether. With that little bit of housekeeping taken care of, we're able to continue. And what we want to do is, because our data carries some ID information for the particular lesson that the user just completed, we can take this opportunity to actually load that data. So the event just carried an ID, and now we want to, from our database, load that data. In this case, we're actually loading the lesson metadata from Sanity. And so we call that, and again, it's a wait step run, get lesson with module. So this calls this function, it awaits it, it returns, and what we have is the lesson with module. We actually get that data back. So we continue down here, and we're going to check and see if that first lesson email has been received. So that gets us into if we can send that email. So here we go. We're actually to the part where we send an email. And in this case, we want to get the user's progress. So we get their overall progress throughout the entire course, right? We're going to use ingest, and we're going to send an event. And what we are doing is requesting that our email get written for us. You can see down here, AI email is the next step. And what this one is doing is actually waiting for an event as a response. Before we take a look at that function that has the steps that generate the actual email text, here are two different ways you can think about this. One, which I'm labeled AI fail here, is you send the event, you ask GPT to generate your email text. You have a single prompt. The AI writer generates the draft from that prompt. The email is complete. And what you end up with is something that's just frankly kind of crappy. Instead, what we're going to do is actually chain a series of prompts where each prompt builds on the last. The AI writer generates a draft that's sent to an editor prompt that is sent back to the AI writer prompt so it can apply those changes. An editor applies final tweaks, and then we actually have a prompt that checks the JSON data structure to make sure it's correct and formatted and will parse. Finally, then the email is complete and you have an email that is perfectly acceptable. So here's what this actually looks like in code, right? So we send out the email writing request event and that triggers this function. So this looks very similar, right? Like we have the export write an email ingest create function. We have that configuration. We have the trigger. We get our event and our step. In this case, we sent some progress along because we want to take that progress data and use that as input for our prompt. And so we break that apart and build some structured data because you pay by the token when you send to OpenAI's API. So we're just trying to reduce that a little bit. And we do that by just parsing the data. So we get that data in, we parse it, we put it in a structured format, and then we write a system prompt. So our system prompt is just kind of telling GPT what it is we want it to do. Now we have the writer prompt, and in this case, we tell the GPT that Cody the Koala is who you are, and you have this lovely koala that you like to sign your emails with. We define the task, we define the motivation, we have important considerations, and with our first step, we are waiting for an AI response. So we call step run, send to writer for first draft. This simply calls OpenAI APIs and uses the chat completions API to create our first part of the conversation. We have the system prompt up here, and then we have this first user prompt that we passed in. So once that response is returned, we're going to move down to our editor prompt. And again, we are going to wait for a response. So we get to our next step. This step runs. Each one of these is executed as an individual function call. So in this case, we're deployed to Vercel. So when this step runs, this is an individual function call. Ingest takes all of these steps inside of the function and then calls as needed to execute them. So each one is an individual function call. You're not waiting for this entire thing to process. You're waiting for this single step to process. So here we go. Same thing. We get the response back. We take the AI writer's revision, give them a new prompt. And at each step of the way, we're including each of the previous prompts and responses. And finally, we get down here. We send an event notifying that the writing is done. And this is where our email writing request completed event happens. So back inside of our lesson completed function, now that we've received the email writing request completed event, we can proceed. So when we come back over, we have this data that comes back with the event in an asynchronous way. So it's awaiting this. It doesn't proceed until this event occurs. So we come down here and we're able to get the options for this particular email. And in the next step, we're going to send the first lesson of the module completed email. This calls the send email function. Behind the scenes, we're using React Email, which is very nice. Here I am inside of the actual workshop on a lesson, and I'm going to go ahead and mark it as complete. All right, so inside of the dev server, we see that our events were received. So lesson completed was received. It's in progress. If we come down here, we can see that it's waiting for the email completed event. And if we come into our GPT-4 email writer, we can see that these steps have started to execute. So send to writer for first draft. And we've already got one response back. And there we go. Kudos, Joel. You're making progress. It really loves to put this koala emoji everywhere. And you can see it just builds this text out. We send it to the editor for suggestions. They bring that back to us. And this proceeds until the events have completed and the process is done. So here is the actual email that it sent me. It came up with an extremely reasonable email. You can expand this workflow. You can expand the number of events that are handled. You can use this process iteratively to build an entire communication stack that you fully own and control inside of your code base and workflows that are endless, processes that you haven't even thought of yet. You're going to be able to create them in a way that allows you to focus on the interactions and the work at hand instead of maintaining all of that infrastructure.